Hello and welcome to this episode of Denny's Tips. Today, you'll be learning one of the most useful type of layer in Photoshop, a layer that you should be using whenever you can. And this layer is called a smart object. What is a smart object? Well, in simple terms, it's the evolution of a layer, and it's smarter, way smarter. Unlike a regular dumb layer, you can resize smart objects up and down as many times as you like, and they won't lose any image quality. Smart objects can also have layers inside of them, so they're essentially a Photoshop document inside of your Photoshop document. You can also apply filters to smart objects, and they'll turn into smart filters, which lets you go back and edit the filter settings at any time. There's a lot of benefits to using smart objects, and if you're not using it yet, well, you're definitely not getting your money's worth. So if you want to make the most out of Photoshop, then keep watching and you'll learn 5 ways to improve your workflow with smart objects. Reason number 1, it's better than merging layers. Let's say that you have a lot of layers that you want to merge into a single layer, so that you can apply some sharpening to it. Most people know why you shouldn't merge your layers together, because once they're merged, you can't access those individual layers anymore. So what they do instead is they create a merged copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl+Shift+Alt+E or Cmd+Shift+Option+E on Macs. And by doing this, they get to keep all of the original layers, and they have a new layer that's essentially a merged copy of all of the layers. Now they can, for example, apply a smart sharpening filter to this layer. That's technically non-destructive editing, but it's not future-proof non-destructive editing. If you need to make any changes to the layers, you have to delete the merge layer and do everything again. A better way to merge the layer is to convert it into a smart object. Here's how to do it. Select all of the layers that you want to merge. Right-click on the layer, and then choose Convert to Smart Object. Now you can apply the Smart Sharpen filter, and if you need to edit any of the layers, you can just double-click on the thumbnail, and Photoshop will open it in a new document, and you can make any changes to the layers in here. When you're done, just save and close the document, and your smart object will be updated automatically. By doing it like this, you don't have to redo a bunch of steps. Reason number 2, fully editable filters. Here's another reason why you should use smart objects. After applying a filter to a layer, you'll see it listed here. This is a smart filter, and unlike regular dumb filters, you can double-click on the smart filter and change the settings at any time. It's super convenient and also super flexible. What I mean by flexible is that you can apply multiple filters like this, and it'll appear in your layers panel as a stack of filters. You can rearrange the filters like this, and you can also double-click on this icon here to change the blending mode and opacity. Using smart filters with smart objects is an incredible way to combine multiple filters and minimize the number of layers that you have in your Photoshop document. Reason number 3, smart objects let you transform non-destructively. Before you make any transformation to a layer, you should always convert it to a smart object. If we transform a regular layer by pressing Ctrl or Cmd and make it smaller like this, and then now we're going to enlarge it back up, you can see that the image quality drops a lot. But if we convert the layer into a smart object first, we can make an unlimited amount of transformations, and the image quality will always be the same. Another benefit is that it remembers your transformation settings. So let's say that you made a transformation to this layer, and you want to undo it and restore the original image size. Well, if we use the transform tool again by pressing Ctrl or Cmd, you can see in the options bar that Photoshop remembers your transformation settings. So you can restore the original image size simply by typing 100% for the width and height. Reason number 4, smart objects automatically update themselves. Here's an example of a Photoshop document that utilizes multiple smart objects. But if I want to make some changes to a smart object, does it mean that I need to do it for all of the layers? Nope. Because we use smart objects, we can just double-click on the thumbnail, make any changes that we want, and when we're done, just save and close the document. Since all of these smart objects are essentially the same document, the changes that I made gets updated on all of these smart objects. Using smart objects like this keeps things simple, and it saves you a lot of time. Reason number 5, linking to external files. Here's the final reason to use smart objects. There's two types of smart objects, an embedded smart object and a linked smart object. An embedded smart object is like a Photoshop document inside of your Photoshop document. But with a linked smart object, the file is stored outside of your Photoshop document as a separate file on your computer. Why would anyone need this? It's useful when you're using the same graphic in multiple Photoshop documents. For example, here I have multiple photos opened, and I want to place my watermark on all of them. But my watermark is just a temporary one that I know I will change at a later time. So to place my watermark, I can go to the File menu, and here you can see two options. Place Embedded, which will place your image as an embedded smart object, and Place Linked, which will place the image as a linked smart object. We're going to choose Linked, and when I import the image, it's not actually going to save the image in the Photoshop document, it's only going to link to it. As an example, I'm going to do this for all of the photos that I have opened in Photoshop. So because we use a linked smart object, all of the documents are referencing the same file. We can edit the watermark in two ways. First, you can simply replace the watermark file with a different file. Another way is to go into a Layers panel and double-click on the thumbnail. If it can edit the file in Photoshop, it'll open it as a new document and you can make any changes that you want, and then save and close the document. By the way, if your linked smart object is something else like an Adobe Illustrator file, it'll actually open it in Adobe Illustrator instead. And the process is the same, just make your changes and then save and close the file. As you can see here, all of our photos have been updated with the new watermark, and it was as simple as editing the watermark file. Guys, thanks for watching this video. Smart objects are amazing. Once you get into a habit of using it, it's going to make your workflow so much more efficient. So give it a try. If you have any questions, just let me know in the comments below. Anyways, thanks again for watching. I hope you have an awesome day, and I'll catch you guys next week with another video.